Hello, I'm Mr. Arnicker, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity. Nanak was the second coming of Jesus, and he came in 1469. Hardly anybody knows, because gospel is by grace of our Father. Those who seek gospel, they don't want money. They give it, receive it free, they give it free. India is the greediest country. Over there, nobody will do you any job without taking bribery. Bribery is the order of the day. And this Amritsar is the epicenter of the crooks of the world. Kashmir produces emperors of darkness, and people suffered under them. Today they are repaying the debt of atrocities. So here I am doing a gospel, Luke 16 verse 1 to 13, in which Jesus stresses, you know, that these temple priests, like this Pope, they loved Mammon. It was an organization of Mammon, nothing to do with God. Whereas the Samaritan village rabbis, they were devoted to God and they produced high quality fruit. Now Jesus said to his brethren, you know, when Messianic Jews, they took over the church, they bring in their Torah and the temple practices, in which they had a temple high priest and all that organization. So they established the same one in the church of God. And when the apostle used to come and saw them reading Torah, and they desireth not the new wine, they rebuked the bishop and left the churches, open monasteries. So the church became corrupt by the end of the first century. And you can see how the Pope was killing people, apostles, live by throwing them before animals. So here is the comparison Jesus is doing between Mammon and God. Jesus said to his brethren and our workers, and not to the once born disciples of the rabbis who were natural men, boys of 12 to 16 years old who need to be disciplined through moral laws. The root of the word disciple is discipline. A rich man, God, our Father, you know, very rich, had a steward, temple high priest, who was reported to him for squandering his property. That means those people who were honest to God, when they found that the rabbis and the temple high priest, they are an organization of the crooks doing wrong things, then they reported to our Father God, send us your own priest. They are too crook to be dealt with. That is why Simeon, he was in the temple and he was watching all those crook people. And he, when Jesus came, welcomed him that you are the Savior. And without you, people have been fleeced by these temple high priests. A rich man, God, had a steward, temple high priest, who was reported to him for squandering his property. He summoned him and said, what is this I hear about you? Prepare a full account of your stewardship, because you can no longer be my steward. He was so bad that God rejected him straight away. That is, I am going to replace you with royal priests. The only temple priests are just priests. priest get 10th of the crops, and they won't do their job proper. And that's why Jesus condemned them, called them hypocrite and all that. And they were sticking to their job because they were getting money from the people. 1/10 of each crop. Rich, they were rich. Mammon loving. But they were not doing the justice they were demanded of. The steward said to himself, or devised a plan to become popular as the Jews did by making the Gentile Jews through circumcision. You remember that which is the tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac and his seed only. You know, circumcision is the tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac and his seed. He did not give it to Ishmael or the Gentile. Today, you see, people in India, Pakistan, Iran, they are Aryan race. They are not Semitic race. They are all circumcised. Are they the sons of Isaac, a Semitic man? No. They are the fake sons of Abraham. And they were making it, you know, at that time through rituals and other things. And Jesus warned them that you go a long, long way to put a millstone of ritual around the necks of the people, which you can't bear yourself. And they invited a temple priest, summoned our brother, angel Stephen. Stephen was not a saint, he was an angel, perfect in the moral law, sitting in the seat of John the Baptist. So they called him to why he was baptizing Jewish men in the name of Abraham, which they did not like. They wanted to make Jew outwardly, not of the heart. He was making the Jew of the heart, making the people outwardly of Judah tribe and are the tribal people. So the other Judah people who were making from Judah to Judaism, Judaism to Jew, who had become Jew outwardly and replaced their Judah tribe with Jew to become super bastard fanatic devils. John 8 verse 44. So they were not happy. So they called him into the temple, the head office of the people of Judah tribe. They were dominant. And over there, our brother angel Stephen, he gave a good account of Abraham, that he is a noble man. And do not make fake sons of Abraham. And keep to his lineage. They were putting fingers in their ears, grinding their teeth, because he was stifling their business, money business. They were Mammon worshippers in the temple. So they killed him. And today, the same one is going to kill them. So then you can't blame a third person. They created they have created their own enemies through fake circumcisions. So the fake sons will kill the Jews. From 2018 to onward, you will see how they will be in trouble. Up to 2018, they are protected because it will be 70 years. After 70 years, no protection. So Abraham to Isaac and his seed only, what shall I do now that my master is taking the position of steward away from me? That means from priest to royal priest. That why Jesus died on the cross. And the curtain of the holiest of holy torn apart from top to bottom, mean from temple high priest to the village rabbi. Out you go. Have a direct approach to God. That is, the dishonest psychic priests are no more needed, but the honest to God royal priest of the master God. Royal priests, they are sealed to serve God. The psychic are not. Here it is, show you which are the royal priest. This is the once born people, the stooges. You see them in churches and other places. They are many. Out of them, some are of spirit, of discerning intellect. So they were the people who were reported to our Father God that the temple priest is squandering your wealth. And these people, when they get spirit, Holy Spirit, they are doubting stage. They become clever. They listen, but they don't preach. Those who are sealed to serve God, they listen and they preach. They open their mouth. They are called Holy Ghost, Holy Father, Holy Son. So these people of Holy Ghost, they reported to our Father God that these priests are crook. They are squandering your money or your wealth, which is His word. They were corrupting the Old Testament and giving corrupt instruction to the people. No more good against the Samaritan village rabbi who were honest, and they were giving different type of education or moral laws which were not corrupted, and they produce a good quality crop. I will come to that later. So psychic priest, those people are psychic, you know, are Holy Spirit one, whereas the sealed to serve God, they are not psychic. They are straightforward. You like it or you reject it. Yes or no. That is, the dishonest psychic priests are no more needed, but the honest to God, sealed to serve God, royal priest of the Master God, who give their own accounts to God. In Jesus, we are solitary. We make other people solitary. We don't make a following. Only the blind follow others. Only the psychic make following. As in churches, you know, these priests are psychic. Everything they give you, sugar-coated sermon, which are of falsehood. If I go there and tell them the gospel truth, they hate me. The Church of England, headed by Queen, she the head of Mammon, what she had to do with God, and she the defender of their faith. And the faith is, when the soldiers die during the World War I or World War II, in the expansion of her empire, she proclaimed that glorified God. What type of God was that? Who was glorified by killing people? Salvation Army people, they served people and they hate them. They are nearer to God than the Church of England people. They are near to Satan. So when I tell them that this Church of England is a Church of Satan, oh, they get into fire, you know, they blow me out of the church. The royal priest of the Master God, who give their own accounts to God. You have to give your own account to God, so you can't give the account of somebody who follow you. These priests, they make a following. I am not strong enough to dig, and I am ashamed to beg. You know, remember Jesus gave the last parable in the temple about the wine press. The wine press is the Jerusalem school of theology, where they were making moral laws, which are the old wine. So over there, you know, that Jesus told them, these husbandmen of the wine press, they are good for nothing. They can't beg. They can't do any other job than this priestly job or the rabbi. So they will be useless. That's what he here is saying, that I'm ashamed to beg. They only knew ruling people. Whenever they went to a house, they wanted the highest position. Remember the parable of the wine press. Somebody came in Reading, you know, there's a Messianic Jews who who are welcomed in a church in the south of Reading. And I went to attend there. Somebody came from Jerusalem, Messianic Jews, and he starts boasting about Daniel, this and that, prophet this. And I asked him, do you know the wine press that Jesus described in the last parable? Where is it? Can you tell me where it is situated? He had no idea. And then he asked the priest over there, do you know it? No idea. Any congregation? No. Then I told them it's the Jerusalem temple. But they hate me. And they won't inform me of anybody coming now. I told them to send me email, but they won't. I know what I should do so that when I'm removed from the stewardship or sacked from the temple, they may welcome me. The crook into their homes. He's a crook, you know, this temple priest. So they said, how can they can invite me? I'm a crook. Unless the other people become blind, then you can play psychic tricks. He called in his master's debtors, the rabbis working under him, under the temple high priest, the master crook, as today you have Pope, one by one. To the first he said, how much do you owe my master? He replied, 100 measures of olive oil. He said to him, here is your promissory note. Sit down and quickly write one for 50. That means corruption in the script or scriptures. So they start making corruption in the scriptures to lure the people. And that's what the story of the Abraham and Ishmael is different from Abraham and Isaac. In the Abraham and Ishmael story, there's a repulsion of Satan before Ram is given to them. Whereas in the story of Abraham and Isaac, there's no repulsion of Satan and they are sitting and eating Ram. How can they eat Ram without repulsing the Satan? So it's a corrupted version. And that is what they started to do, you know. That is how crooks collude together to cheat you even today. These all these monetary banks and other things, you know, they all collude together and they design fashions, ways to cheat you. They corrupted the scriptures so that people are kept lured into their trap, such as a Jew is one who is outwardly of appearances and forget about inwardly of heart or spiritual. So they told them, what, forget about spirituality, just put on this dress, you know, dress yourself and that is enough. Then to another he said, and you, how much do you owe? He replied, 100 cores of wheat. He said to him, here is your promissory note, write one for 80. So the head priest, temple high priest, he was the main crook, you know, who was asking them to how to corrupt the scriptures. He will approve it, and the Pope will approve. Now the Pope is approving the saint. They have made this old bishop, German bishop, a saint. Now, how could he be a saint when he was not a solitary? He was heading an organization of the Antichrist. Anybody who stands between man and God is Antichrist. The docular priest, they are Judas Iscariot in sheep's clothing. One by one, the rabbis corrupted the scriptures, and the master commended that dishonest stewards for acting prudently or cleverly. Master is there, temple high priest, not our Father God. He can't command these crook people. So the master temple high priest, that is was their master, you know, temple high priest. Because in God we don't have a master, we have Father. So temple high priest commanded that dishonest steward for acting prudently and are cleverly changing the scripture to please their clients. How could our honest Father will command a crook? No way. No way, but corruption in the New Testament too. They have corrupted the New Testament too when they occupied the Church of God by bringing the Jewish leaven Torah. For the children of this corrupt world are more prudent in dealing with their own generation than are the children of light, the apostles. Children of this world means when you go meet people, you will see how crooked they are. Everywhere they want to cheat you. And the people of light, they don't. They are honest. They don't cheat. Otherwise, they can't live. Their heart get dirty. Then the Satan is sitting here. Christ can't come into your heart if you are not truthful. And what is inside is outside. Then Christ sits in your heart. Otherwise, Satan is sitting in your heart. And this becomes the temple of Satan. As these wars and other things taking place in Syria, this is all the acts of the sons of the Satan. They are not honest. Children of light, the apostles are the royal priests who give to the church and not steal from the church purses. Now, if you ask these church-going people, what is the difference between priest and royal priest? They have no idea. So the royal priest, you know, they opposite to priest. Priest used to get 1/10 of the crop and all that. These are getting money, salary, you know. Royal priest, they give to the church that they have fellowships. They have no priest because there is no greater than royal priest. So these church-going people, they don't know who is royal priest, but the priest will tell them, you are royal priest. And they are, when they told royal priest, they are very happy, you know. And then he will tell them, gospel is for everyone. So gospel is buried under the parables. He himself doesn't know, and he will tell them it's for everyone. So you can see what type of crook things are happening in the churches, and when people suffer, as they are going to suffer in America, black and white riots are going to flare up, and you will see how they kill each other. Guns, those who take to sword shall die by the sword, and not steal from the church purses as the hireling dog collar priest, Neo-Rabbis, do in the fashion of Judas Iscariot. Judas Iscariot used to steal money from the purse. And that is why at the end, Jesus threw him out, that you are not worthy of our the Father's house. You can't enter into that house because you are a money lover. You are a thief. And that's what happened when the marriage of the son was performed. Wedding banquet was enjoying everybody. Then Father appears. And he found one man not properly dressed, and that man was Judas Iscariot. Now ask the Church of England priests how God is glorified by killing the people for the sake of Mammon. When the empire was expanded in the World War I, World War II, the soldiers who died, they say they glorified God. Stupid are the people who believe in them. So that is what I mean. Gospel is not for everyone, but for people of discerning intellect. There are people who are against it. They put white puppies. And the red puppies are by those who say they glorified God. I tell you, make friends for yourself with dishonest wealth. Dishonest wealth means this corruption, not hard-earned money, not honest money, cheating, and other thing. You become rich as Lazarus was at the gate of a rich man who had corrupted, who had made the money by corruption. So that when it fails, then it can't stand because corrupt thing fail, you know. Then you revert back into the royal kingdom of God. Now you are sensible enough when you are making corrupt money. If you change your way and turn to the royal kingdom of God to become honest person, because God can't sit in this temple, can't be of God if you are a dishonest person. You are a temple of Satan. Then Christ sit in your heart and guide you all this thing as it is guiding me today. You will be welcomed into the eternal dwelling, resurrection as shown in Lazarus. In Jesus showed in Lazarus, who was the friend of Jesus. Friend means the same quality. In him, Jesus showed to everyone that what his word will bring you. When you preach gospel, you become eternal like our Father. You have become the Son of the Most High. But when Jesus himself died and resurrected, only those who believed in him could see him. To otherwise, no way. So if you can't believe what you see in Lazarus, how can you believe in Jesus then? The person who is trustworthy in very small matters, scriptures, is also trustworthy in great ones, the gospel, as demonstrated by the Samaritan woman at well. In there, you know, John 4 gospel, which is twisted, the five husbands were spiritual husbands, which I have explained in this Trinity. You can copy it and you can see these names of those five husbands. And so, when she came and told Jesus, vetted Jesus in spirit, she told him that you are a prophet, that she was qualified enough. She had a discerning intellect to test Jesus or vet him. And she also told him, there's a greater than a prophet, which is Christ. And when Christ come, he will tell us everything. So in Christ, we tell us everything because we have learned things through logical reasoning. Logo sits in your heart, not in the book. Book can't give you logical reasoning. Your heart can give you. And the person who is dishonest in very small matters, our scripture, is also dishonest in great ones, gospel. That is why they corrupted the gospel also, these messianic Jews, and put the word disciple and Lord and other thing. Lords have slaves, father has sons. So if people can't understand the difference between slave and all the other thing, you know, small thing, he can't understand the gospel truth then. You have to make effort. I also made mistake. I used to write disciple. A friend of mine from Wigan, who was in his soldier, became priest. He was good. He told me, Mr. Nidja, do you know the root of the word disciple? I said, no. It's a discipline, as we discipline soldiers in the forces. Then I knew. So disciple were the natural men, young boys, 12 to 16 years old. When they go to school, they are taught moral of Moses, which is scripture written, and they are subject to sin. But we are grown up, we are not disciple. People who are discerning, we are workers and laborers in the vineyard of our Father. If therefore you are not trustworthy with dishonest wealth, dealing in mammon, the scriptures, who will trust you with the true wealth, gospel, or his word. You know, there are two wealth. You have the mammon, which is money. You become rich as Judas Iscariot was stealing money. He was dishonest in the small one, and he could not be given the gospel truth, which is the treasures of our Father. You can't buy with the money. They rest in your heart where no thief can steal, no rust, nothing like that. They keep shining. Every day keep shining. If you are not trustworthy with what belongs to you, what belongs to another, as in banking, people how they steal, who will give you what is yours? That means when you are in the company of cheats, you cheat each other, as these politicians are doing, America especially. What they are doing in Syria, you can see they are, money makes the mayor go. In America, is dominated by the Jewish media and money. And that is dominating the war in Syria and around. Because these Jewish people are being bundled up for final burning. Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30. So they are cleaning around themselves, all these areas, so they are safe and sound. Saddam Hussein pointed gun at them and they killed him. And so are they doing this other destructions. Up to 2018, they will do it. They will show their full colors. Then you will see the anti-Semitic feeling in the all over the world, and people will start killing them, as they did in 66 AD. When the Jews in the villages, they were getting killed, and they ran to Jerusalem for protection. Then Roman built a wall around it. For 4 years they suffered, and this time is going to suffer 5 years before the atomic war in 2023, 14 May 2023, when Israel is 75 years old. So these 5 years will be in which the conscience of the people will be vetted, because Christianity is of conscience. Dirty conscience bear dirty fruit. Holy conscience, good conscience bear out of the goodness of the heart good things. Or in a word of crooks, each one takes the skin of others. In this world of mammon, can you trust somebody? No way. Trust is lost in mammon. No servant can serve two masters. He will either hate one and love the other, or be devoted to one and despise the other, as Judas Iscariot proved. He had one leg in the temple, one leg in the Jesus fold. At the end, he loved mammon for 30 shekels when Jesus threw him out that you are not fit in to be baptized. Eucharist is the baptism of Jesus in Holy Spirit. Before he started giving them the Eucharist, he threw him out after Last Supper. Okay, now you go and do your job. You are not fit for the Eucharist. Eucharist was not given to Judas Iscariot, only to 11. You cannot serve God and mammon. This applies to these hireling dog-collared priests in the churches. Super blind, worse than those temple priests. To get rid of them, Jesus died on the cross. Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45 is fulfilled in these dog-collared priests. So when I tell them, dog-collared priest, what part you play in Christianity, everyone has to give his own account to God. Can you give their account to God, the people who follow you? Oh, they get angry with me, especially in Oxford, And never mind. Once you have the gospel truth in your heart, then your foundation is sound. They are building their houses on sand. And when you test them, they fall down. When somebody asks me anything, I give them a sound answer. So my foundation is sound. That is how you should build your foundations strong. Gospel is like a subject like chemistry. I study chemistry, I become a chemist. You have to study chemistry and go to university to learn chemistry or somehow, and then you are qualified to become a chemist. Same is gospel. You have to make your own effort to learn it. I can't give you, nobody can give you gospel. Parable of 10 virgins. Faith, which is gospel treasures. More gospel treasures you have, the greater is the faith, greater is the oil in your lamp. Those people who put the light under bushel, psychic. The five of them, you know, they had nothing. They were just praising like these dog-hole priests, you know, gospel is for everyone, another thing. So when they went to the door of our Father, the first one, five, they knocked on the door, called Abba, Abba, Father, Father, Father. Oh, your sons, come in. Welcome. The other psychic, you know, when they are these priests, you know, if I tell them it is wrong to call Jesus a Lord or God a Lord, we will call him. It looks better, you know, than calling him a just Father. And they say their stooges, when I ask them it's wrong, it's antichrist to call God a Father, a Lord. He's our Father. No, he's our Lord. So such stooges, when they went to the gate and knocked, Lord, Lord, open the door. He said, I don't make slaves. I set people free. And I love my people like my sons. So I'm the father of my people who are my sons. I'm not the lord of the slaves. Go and get lost. So he kicked them out. And still you can see people calling Lord, Lord, Lord in the churches. You can see how blind they are. So gospel is by grace, and you should stick to gospel. Don't do what the other people do. Don't follow the fashion of the world. Keep honest, because God is worshipped in truth and in spirit. Truth, if you are a liar, as the politicians are, then you are a crook. So these psychic priests in the churches, they are number one crook. And politicians, super hypocrites. And you want peace in the world? No way. Our Father God blesses you.